We used the Gradle wrapper way back at the start of this class to run our first task, before we had even installed Gradle. That's a pretty cool party trick, but the real strength of the wrapper is that you can put your build tool under version control, so everyone building your project is building it with the exact same tool. The Gradle wrapper is composed of four files: a jar, a properties file, and a pair of scripts, a shell script for Unix and Mac, and a batch script for Windows. When you pass a command to one of these scripts, it will first check if Gradle is installed, download it if necessary, then execute your command. A wrapper can be created by running the built-in wrapper task. Here we go, let's give it a try. And here we see the files of the Gradle wrapper, the two build scripts, and then inside the Gradle directory, we'll find the Gradle wrapper.jar and the Gradle wrapper.properties. We can now run our Gradle build using the wrapper. We use the wrapper identically to how we would use the Gradle command. Let's get our task list. Oops, looks like we don't have this version of Gradle installed. Since this was our first time using the wrapper, it went ahead and downloaded the appropriate Gradle distribution and cached it locally. We can also explicitly configure what version of Gradle we want the wrapper to use by setting the Gradle version property of the wrapper task. Let's change the version to 2.2 and run the wrapper task again. Now if we use this new wrapper to get the task list, it'll have to download Gradle again because we don't already have version 2.2. If we run Gradle --version to see which version we're actually using here, looks like we're using version 2.2, just like we asked for. Configuration options of the Gradle wrapper is stored in this Gradle wrapper properties file. We've got it opened up down here. As you can see, what URL to get Gradle from is defined here. It's currently using Gradle version 2.2, just like we set from the build file. Let's change this back to 2.3. Now if we try running Gradle W version again, we see we're back on version 2.3. This is a really important feature, as it allows us to centrally control what version of Gradle is used to build our project. In practice, the Gradle wrapper files, including the scripts, jar, and properties file, will be committed to source control. This serves two main functions. First, it means that everything that is needed to get up and running with development of our project is included in the source repository. Second, it means that the Gradle version is also version controlled, which eliminates the possibility that a developer encounters problems with the build due to using the wrong version of Gradle.